Hello and welcome back to another episode of Powerslide Speaking Specs. You may or may not have seen one of our heat molding videos already, but just to catch you up, heat molding is the process, as the name suggests, of using heat to mold the shell of your boot to help it fit better. And even our Powerslide SWELL skates, like this one here, can be heat molded. So it's not just really a high performance thing. Well, it is a high performance thing, but it goes down into all the models. So you're gaining all those benefits to help the skate fit better. And what that's going to do is not only going to perform better, it's going to allow you to have more fun skating. So really, I advise you to take the time to do it. And it's quite a simple process.
Yeah, we are here with a Trinity model. So we get a lot of questions if SWELL is heat model. It is heat moldable, but we don't really promote it too much. Because we have the recoil fit, so normally it's right out of the box, it's quite nice and good fitting. And we have a nylon shell with fiberglass, so it's also heat moldable, but not like a carbon fiber at 120 degrees, but we have to go like at 80 degrees, so not overheated. So it's important for a SWELL skate to heat it like more constantly and with a lower heat. So it will take about also like 12 to 15 minutes to make it warm and to make the fiberglass reinforced plastic shell a little bit softer and more forgiving then. So first we put it in and then we wait until it comes out.
So, and as you're seeing here, this is a MyFit oven, Powerslide's heat molding brand. But at the same time, you can use it in your regular oven at home. So you don't need a special oven for it, simply can just do it at home. As you see with the skate here, we've removed the wheels and things, because that's really important, because you don't want to put urethane in your oven and things like that. Also super important, pay attention to all the metal parts, so the frame, the eyelets, the little levers on the buckles and things like that, because when they come out, it's going to be very, very hot. So after 12 to 15 minutes, just simply remove your SWELL skate out of the oven. Again, you don't need to do it in a MyFit oven. Remember that all the aluminium parts or metal parts will be very, very hot. Simply just
open it up. Yep. If you have some pressure points, you know, if you want to make it a little bit wider, you know, you can put some tissues in, and or, you know, have pressure points on the ankle or here. You know, some people have here a little extra bone, which I do, for example. So you can put a little bit extra tissues in here. So you stuff it out a little bit longer. Then you have to see, does it fit really well? And you can take out the inner sole or not. I prefer it without inner sole, so I sit a little bit lower and have more control. So get in. I also like it when it's really tight, so I have a rather small foot, and then really tight it nicely, step by step. So it wraps around your foot. Here on this new model, we actually also have the lacing up going all the way to the top. So you can lace it, and like this, the upper wraps around nicely. Make sure, you know, the tongue is in place. It's not, you know, going to the side, because this is how it will be fixed. So make sure everything is nice and snug and fitting and really tight. Watch out here, the metal buckles get a little bit hot. Tied it nicely.
Also too, basically you'll know when it's finished the heat molding process, when it simply cools down. That's how long you should stay in the boot and maintain the position.
Yeah, so then the important, the position. Put your knee right over the toe, so you have a little bit forward lean and you have an angle, and then let it cool down. So the plastic will stretch a little bit, or if you want it, you can also like squeeze it together and can make it a little bit more narrow. Make sure it's all tight. Even if it's like really tight when you heat mold it, later when you want to skate a little bit loose, that's no problem to skate. It'll open up everything a little bit, the buckles and the laces, and skate a little bit loose. But the shape of the foot will fit you really well if you tight it first well when you heat molding it.
And again, this is a process which can be done multiple times. It's not just something that can only be done one and done. You do have the chance to remodify it again if it doesn't fit 100% the first time.
And also, heat molding is just one of the things when you really set up your skates well. Make sure also you sit nice and tight inside the skate, so the heel really move up. So it's really well and good so if you sometimes put your heel down.
So the heel really sits back into that heel cup. Yeah. That, when we design the skates, it's all designed about to be perfectly fitting. So for example, if your boot's sitting, if your heel's sitting too far forward, then that also affects the ankle position. So if you really drop all the way back in, then it's going to fit nice and snugly.
Yeah. Normally, also what we say, when you stand like this, you can the toes can touch the front. But when you're in skating position, then your heel moves back and also the toe moves back. And there should be a little bit of space on the front. So for me, this it's even it's small, it really fit in perfectly. So that's really important. And it's not only important you heat mold the skates, but also before you skate, set it up to your preferences. So the frames can be adjusted front to back and side to side. For example, when you tend to fall to the inside with the skate, then move the frame a little bit more to the inside. When you have more falling to the outside, then you move the frame a little bit to the outside so you have a better balance and have more control when you're skating.
So with this video, basically what we're trying to show you is not only customizable with fit, but also customizable in setup. So basically it allows you to tailor-make the skate, really customizing it for your skating needs, not only your body shape or your physical preferences, but generally what feels good, because that's the most important thing with skating.
Yeah, so when it's done and heat molding, it should be really, it feels like a second skin and feels like you're part of the skate and everything. It's really fitting around nicely. There's no open space here. Everything is fully covered and wrapping around nicely. So it's really one piece wrapped around like an extra sock of skate. So that's how I like it, really tight and snug. And then you won't have any heel lift, you won't have any blisters because you're not moving in the skate. And this then it's also the right size for you.
Thanks for watching this episode of Powerslide TV. It's something simple you can just do at home. As Matthias said, he likes it nice and tight and snug. And remember, we love to skate.